has gone into the various details of the last 1 year activities as well as our future. And I request Comrade George Mavrikos to place his report. Comrade George Mavrikos.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. First of all, also from my side, I want to thank you for all our comrades from Sepau, Nehau, Nomsa, and Poptru for the last night. It was an inspiring evening in reality. Thank you very much, dear comrades. Dear comrades, we are meeting 10 months after the historic Congress of our organization, which strengthened the World Federation of Trade Unions. 10 months after the 16th World Trade Union Congress, where the WFTU showed that it's alive and strong, that it represents the international crash-oriented trade union movement, and it is able to organize open and democratic congresses. 10 months after that, the decisions that we took, the Athens Pact, is not only a question of present interest, but also proves the right analysis that we made for today's politico-economic situation and what we are ready to organize the struggle in a better way. We meet in South Africa, in the country with a rich history of struggles, and we express our respect and our appreciation to this country and its people. We express our thanks to the leadership of Nomsa, Nehau, Sepau, and Poptru for their hospitality, their reception, and their cover of such meeting with the participation of high-level trade unionist leaders from 28 countries of the 5 continents. We thank all those who have helped us to be here today. We thank our members and friends for their contribution to the beginning of functioning of the regional office that we hope to become the base positive instrument for the militant trade union movement. Dear colleagues and friends, today there are 3 basic characteristic facts in workers' reality and life. First of all, a deepening capitalist crisis together with an effort of the bourgeoisie to lose the minimum possible in the crisis by transferring a big burden to the working class and to the popular layers. The crisis started in the USA, embraced all Europe, and it is expanding throughout the world. The crisis sharpened the intercapitalist rivalries between the euro and the dollar, between Germany and France, and among their allies. The crisis is used and salaries, pension, and social rights are cut while privatization are generalized. The situation is also difficult in most African countries for ordinary people. Colonialism ended, but capitalism continues. Colonialists left and come right back through transnational corporations, cartels, monopolies, through neoconservatives and social democrats governments. Africa is very rich in resources, but it has very poor workers. This is confirmed by the UN data published in December 2010 on, for example, on average life expectancy. Angola, 47 years old. Today, in 21st century, Chad, 49 years old. Lesotho, 47 years old. Mozambique, 49 years old. Rwanda, 49. Nigeria, 49. In total, 16 African countries have average life expectancy under 50 years old. Throughout the world, the great problem for the working class, for youth and working women, is unemployment. The capitalists, under conditions of deep economic crisis, are trying to divide a job among 2-3 part-time employees. Unemployment, however, cannot be faced with such anti-labor policies. It will grow continuously. Just before, President of COSATU said, and also yesterday in our event, we said that on basis of the recent data published by the ILO, there are already 1 billion and more unemployment poor workers in the world. 900 million workers, they live with income only in the name, lower than 2 euros per day. In Spain, more than 5 million unemployed, 3 million in France, 1 million in Greece. In many European countries, the situation it is the same. The total real number of unemployment workers in the European Union expressed 24 million. The majority of them women and young workers. So the immediate task for the unions is to support unemployed workers to survive, to make sure that they have food, electricity, medicines, clean water, that they have economic and social support from the government and the public institutions. At the same time, we need to uncover the causes of unemployment, to make the working class understand that a final solution within capitalism cannot be given. To understand that the struggle against unemployment is a main basic for the WFTU. Second big main characteristic of this period is the tension of intra-imperialist rivalries and their expression through the tough aggressiveness of NATO, European Union and their allies. In the last period, there is a strong imperialist aggression, especially against those people who are resisting the plans of the USA, NATO and their allies. The last period, you saw, for example, in Syria, the foreign imperialist aggressions continues. Arab countries that have kings and reactionary regimes are used to promote the plans of the imperialists. In Libya, the conflict continues, while in the Persian Gulf, the imperialists, the European Union, have imposed an embargo on Iran with the excuse of its nuclear program. At the same time, they have not any problem for the nuclear program of Israel, of Finland, of Pakistan, of many, many other countries. The USA and the European Union also slander socialist Cuba. Israel continues its attacks on the Gaza Strip against the Palestinian people. The government of Turkey threats Cyprus and it used the Muslim Brothers. In fact, Turkish government are the most firm allies of the USA and Israel in the region. The position of the WFTU is firm. The people are the only responsible to decide freely and democratically for the present and future. The WFTU is against the plans of imperialist and against imperialist wars, and it organizes campaigns for internationalism and solidarity with those people suffering from the imperialists. The WFTU affiliates and friends in Nigeria, we need to We want to underline the situation in Nigeria. Because of this, we believe that our members and our friends in Nigeria and in Africa in general needs to be in strangling readiness, because the USA, the transnational corporations, and the international capital have plans for the division of the wealth in Nigeria in two or more states. The third, dear colleagues, characteristic is the strength of the working class and the popular layers that gets more intense of and gives more hope and perspective to the peoples and the workers. The latter fights back and their struggles intensify every day. The example of the great strike in Nigeria, the many months of struggle of SME in Mexico from our member, the strike of steel workers in Greece, the strike of workers in Kazakhstan, in the workers in banana plantation in Panama, also in Canal of Panama, in Portugal, in India, in Thailand, Italy, Poland, Bulgaria, Belgium, etc. In the metal sector, in transnational corporation in South Africa and many other sectors, in the food sector in Colombia, in the mining sector in Peru, also from yesterday in the mining sector in Panama, they started yesterday new strike, in the public sector in England, the youth in Chile, the protesto in Wall Street, etc. All these examples prove that the big, big sections of workers in all continents resist the anti-labor policies applied by the neoliberal or social democratic government. Today, under conditions of deep capitalist crisis, under conditions of decay of the capitalist system, the struggles of workers, of poor peasants, of the youth are the optimistic hope and the only way to generalize the counterattack of workers against the system of capitalist exploitation. Nowadays, under such conditions, dear brothers and sisters, the expressions of internationalist solidarity is more than necessary. On one hand, the struggle of each trade union organization in each country being class-oriented, confronted the employers with acute forms of struggle and keeping pace with other popular layers are a great contribution to the internationalist duty. On the other hand, the expression of solidarity with the struggle of our comrades in other countries should get stronger. This solidarity should be a subject discussed at factories, at workplaces, where workers will be informed, encouraged, and will understand that they are not alone in the struggle, that working class unity at international level can bring positive results inside transnational corporations and strategic branches everywhere. Our efforts should be at such a scale that the various arguments used by governments and the mass media to slander the working class struggles cannot be applied. Another essential aspect of internationalism and workers' solidarity is that the sharing of experience, the use and transmission of the experience for struggles to become more active, to be better organized, and to get better results for the working class. We all have the duty to continuously reinforce the internationalist character of the WFTU. At the same time, dear colleagues, we need to think in this period what kind of trade unions we want today in the current conditions. We ask the leadership of today's FSM, World Federation of Trade Unions, claim that under the conditions we live in the international working class and the people need an international trade union organization which will basically have the following main characteristics, and those are the characteristics that we would like and we try to help the World Federation of Trade Unions. First, class orientation revolutionary thinking, which will emphasize that we are talking about an organization of workers that firmly fights against capital and against imperialism, trade union independent from the governments and capitalists. Second, democratic and open dealing with simple people, reforms at all levels, supporting leaders who will come from the base of society, who will be honest, will respect criticism and self-criticism, and also discipline leaders who will fight bureaucracy and corruption. Three, the kind of unity that will unite the workers, irrespective of sex, color, or religion. It will unite workers, poor farmers, and the youth in order to include them all in the fight. It will unite them in the struggle and teach them not to step back or to give up. Four, its international character, worker solidarity, cooperation and support, both ethical and economic, for each country's working class, for each branch that fight for its freedom, for its trade union and democratic rights, for its life and rights. Five, the use of all kinds of class struggle, from the simple at the most complex, launching ideas and goals that will demand satisfaction of the present day needs of all workers and will at the same time lead to a class struggle. Six, to use and of international organizations to implement the ideas of the workers, coordinating the actions of different movements that are fighting for the same goals. Seven, education for the working class, especially for that the workers will love the history of their nation, the traditions, the culture, and the history of the international working class movement, providing an education to make the workers clever as a class, to believe in the values of the class struggle and to know the class struggle. Dear colleagues, dear brothers, the World Federation of Trade Unions has made many positive steps, but the sector with most difficulties is finances. I believe that the President of Financial Control Committee, later tomorrow, he will give you many details for this topic. The base economic support that the WFTU receives comes only from seven WFTU affiliates, usually from seven WFTU affiliates and friends. Without the assistance of our friends, the situation would be worse. We want to highlight and to thank also the organizations, poor organizations, that every year send us their small but constant contribution. Our organization, for example, from El Salvador, from Colombia, from Guyana, Sri Lanka, they are here, from Bangladesh, sent small amounts of 300 euros or 500 euros, showing that they support our joint efforts. They sent letters saying that we stand together in our struggle. These are small amounts with a very big symbolism. The problem though still remains, and it is a big problem. The needs are also, as you know, very good, big. We underline the fact that WFTU does not receive any money from governments or nor from employers. Dear comrades, for the year 2012, the International Action Day, the WFTU, we as Secretariat suggest to be Wednesday, October 3, 2012. The success of the previous initiatives and the conditions that we live in put is in front of an additional duty for the success of the day, the organization of initiatives by all our members and friends in their countries in their framework of the Action Day. We recall the International Day of Action to promote the needs and the demands of workers for everyone to have food, housing, clean water, free and public health care system and education system, free medicines. We should reveal by data the millions of children dying from hunger and thirst, the millions of people who are starving, who have no medicines, while their countries are rich and their natural resources have been plundered by multinationals and monopolies. An international effort should be made to reveal and condemn the reasons for this social phenomenon. The trade unions that are members and friends of the WFTU, as well as its friends, should let this action at every workplace, in all sectors, in all countries, in order that specific initiatives to take place. Information should be gathered, protest to the organized events to be held as ports, for example, at the expense of multinational companies speculating on water, medicines, food, books, and others. We should demand solutions to be given with no delay. The material gathered after the initiative and the action to the deposit of the UN, ILO, FAO, and UNESCO by big delegations of our affiliates and friends. About the prices of foodstuff, about the cartel in supply and distribution of food and seed. To attempt, in coordination with colleagues from Italy and from Europe, to organize protest in the office of FAO in Rome, in Italy. The 2012 action plan that all of you received, all of you, you as members of Presidential Council, you received 1 week ago, is very rich in initiatives and activities, and they are important, all necessary. The objective of the activities is to strengthen through the trade union movement the participation of young workers and women in trade unions. For this reason, we will organize the meeting of working women, as well as the second international conference of working youth on 29 and 30 April 2012 in Havana in Cuba. We want to strengthen the capability for collective bargaining and trade union freedoms, and we will organize 2 central seminars in each continent. We will organize 4 international trade union congresses in the branches with strategic meaning of energy, transport, pensioners and education inside in 2012. We will organize in this year in Ramallah, in Palestine, a big international conference on March 22, and another one in Brussels on April on the developments in the Arab world. Already the Arab members and friends, they received the invitation. In 2012 also, we will continue our presence and action inside the international organizations such as the UN, ILO, FAO, UNESCO, and we will bring where the voice of workers. In Africa, we will continue to pay even more attention with 2 central objectives: the cancellation of the debt and water, food, medicine, and electricity for all. We will organize in Africa 3 main seminars in the English-speaking and French-speaking Africa, together with the regional office. 2 regional conferences in the English-speaking, French-speaking, and Arab-speaking Africa. Also, we will organize with our colleagues and friends, with comrades from Sudan, from South Africa, from other countries from Africa, trade union education and the with corporation with central offices. Also, we have some initiatives, continue some initiatives on AIDS, HIV. Dear colleagues and friends, in the documents you have received, there is a monthly detailed action plan for this year. Here we will discuss free and democratically for 2 days, and we are convinced the final action plan that will become after your proposals, observations, and criticism will be even richer, more current. Comrades, after the 16th World Trade Union Congress, we are more optimistic. We all got optimistic, encouragement, and strength. The new Presidential Council and the new Secretariat, together with the leadership of the TUAs and the regional offices, have the capability and the strength to respond to our new and difficult but necessary duties. Dear brothers and sisters, to conclude, I want to underline that today and tomorrow we need to discuss about all action plan for 2012, also for our duties. As you know, tomorrow we will decide very general task, and we will decide about this action plan for 2012. And also, after this decision for the basic access, we organized on April common meeting in Athens with Secretariat, with all leaders from our regional offices and our TUIs, our sectoral trade unions, to discuss together with many concrete details about to have very concrete steps for all this action plan, which we will decide tomorrow in the basic access. Thank you for your attention, and we want to listen from your side all your proposals, your criticism, your remarks. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Comrade Jad Mehri Ko, Sabha Secretary, for his